Good morning, children. Welcome back to the English class. Today we are going to revise the remaining lessons. We have already revised Casabianca. Do you remember? We did it yesterday and we have revised everything in Casabianca. Today we are going to revise the remaining chapters. And as you have been told, this time the paper will have only objective type of questions, but different types of objectives. For example, you will have fill in the blanks, multiple choice questions, true or false, and match these columns. So some of these are there in the lessons. We are going to revise them. But then you have to read all the lessons thoroughly. You have to revise questions and answers and the exercises that follow the lesson, because we can base any of these four kinds on anything which is there in the lesson. So you must revise all these very, very thoroughly. Now please take out your Real English book and open lesson number 2. Brave in life, brave in death. In this lesson, you must revise all the words and their meanings. This you have to do for all the lessons, because you can have a lot of multiple choice questions which are on word bank. We can give you the word and ask you for the correct meaning. So you'll have to click on the correct meaning, or we can give you the meaning and ask you for the correct word. So you'll have to click on the correct word. So please learn the word bank of all the lessons properly. The second thing which you have to do is you have to learn the names of the authors and poets wherever these are given. In the lessons done so far and which are coming in the terminal exams, except for Brave in Life, Brave in Death, the name of the poet or the writer is given in all. So you must know the names of all with the correct spellings. In order to test you, sometimes we give you wrong spellings. You think this is the name of the writer or the poet, you click on it, but the spelling is wrong, so you can't get marks. Now let us quickly revise the names of the writers. Do you remember who has written Casabianca? We did it just yesterday. Yes, Felicia Hemans. Now the second one, Brave in Life, Brave in Death. The writer is not mentioned, so we are not going to ask you this. Now the third one again is a poem, The Daffodils. And do you remember who is the poet? William Wordsworth, who is one of the very famous romantic poets, William Wordsworth. Now the next one, The Luncheon. Do you remember this one? I'm sure you must be remembering. Somerset Maugham, though it is a little difficult to pronounce, but the writer is very popular even today and people love to read his stories. The fifth one is a poem again, Abu Ben Adam, and the poet is James Leigh Hunt. Even if you write Leigh Hunt, you are going to get marks. And if somewhere you have Leigh Hunt only as an option, you can very, very confidently click on Leigh Hunt. Now, David Begins a New Life 1 and David Begins a New Life 2 are extracts from a famous novel. Do you know from which novel are these taken? Yes, they are taken from David Copperfield, and the name of the writer is Charles Dickens. So far, we have done 7 lessons, and out of these, only one, Brave in Life, Brave in Death, does not have the name of the writer. Others have So please learn these. Now we come to page number 8, and this is from Brave in Life, Brave in Death. Choose the correct answer. And as you know, this story is about the life of Mirza Manoj, and it is based on true life incidents. Now let us start. Mirza was a young woman, A, of immense self-respect, B, with a lot of pride, and C, with a strong desire for popularity. We know she did not want popularity and she did not have a lot of pride. What she had was immense self-respect. She respected herself, and so she did not give in to the unreasonable demands of dowry from her husband and his family. So which one is the correct option? Immense self-respect. The second one, the plane was hijacked at the Dash airport. Where was the plane hijacked? By 4 heavily armed terrorists at the Karachi airport. If the word airport is given, then you just have to click on Karachi. But if airport is not given, then you have to click on Karachi airport. Now the third one, the 3-member cockpit crew exhibited their A, valor. Valor is another word, a synonym for bravery. B, cowardice, and C, intelligence. Which one is the correct option? Cowardice. They did not show bravery. They did not show intelligence in leaving the plane and running away. It was simply cowardice. Now the fourth one in this exercise is, it began to get dark inside the aircraft because A, one of the hijackers had turned off the lights, B, power began to fail, and C, the sun had set. It had started to get dark because since the power had begun to fail is written in the lesson. So because the power began to fail. Now these can be given in this form like we did just now, or they can be changed to some other form like true or false, or maybe match these columns, match the columns. Now you have A2, which is a flowchart. Then you have answered the following questions, and vocabulary, you have a table which has the qualities which you can see in Mirza, pilot and terrorist. You have to revise all this. Then in vocabulary section, you have B2 and B3, which is on page 10, which is on synonyms and phrasal or prepositional verbs. You could have any of these also in the objective type of questions. So please revise these as well. Now we go to the next one, that is the daffodils. And as I told you, the poet is William Wordsworth. Anything from here can be asked, so you need to revise this poem thoroughly. Something may be asked from what is given about the poet in the box, so you must go through the information on the poet, and of course word bank has to be revised thoroughly. Now we come to complete the following statements of this poem. The first one, one day while walking in the countryside, the poet saw, what did he see? Thousands of golden daffodils. If in the options only daffodils is there, you have to click on daffodils. If it is a large number, thousands, a host, whatever is there, you know that it was a large number of daffodils and lots of daffodils. The second one, the flowers were growing. Where were the flowers growing? Beside the lake and beneath the trees. We may not give you both these in the options. If one is given, then also you have to click on that. Suppose we give beside the lake, then click on that. If beneath the trees is given, then you have to click on that. And if both are given, then of course you will click on that. Now the third one is, the flowers were dashed in the breeze. What were the flowers doing in the breeze? The flowers were fluttering and dancing in the breeze. And you could even write moving in the breeze. And if only fluttering or dancing is given, only one out of these, then you have to click on that one. Now the fourth one, the poet recalls this sight when dash. When does he recall or remember this beautiful sight? When he is in a pensive or vacant mood. Instead of giving these words pensive and vacant, we may give you the meanings that when he is sad or he is worried or he has an empty mind, then also because it is the meaning of these words, you have to click on that. Now the last one has two blanks. These could be given as two different blanks or you could have them as they are here. The poet has compared himself to dash. That is passing over dash. What is he comparing himself to? He has compared himself to a lonely cloud and which is passing over hills and vales. Or vales and hills, or you could write the full form valleys and hills. He has compared the daffodils to dash. What has he compared the daffodils to? The stars that shine in the Milky Way. If you don't have such a long option, if you have only cloud and stars, then you have to click to a lonely cloud and click on it, and if it is daffodils are compared to the stars. Now you have on the other page match the following to make similes, that is on page 16. You may get these as match the following columns. So you must revise these: as loud as thunder, as merry as lark, as quiet as mouse, as ageless as the sun, as afraid as a grasshopper, and as blind as a bat. So these can be given to you. You must revise all these. Now we come to the next lesson, that is the luncheon, and it is written by Somerset Maugham, and you know about him in from the blue box, which has a little bit about him. Please go through the lesson thoroughly and about the information about which is given about the writer. Then you have in this lesson true or false, but this may not come as true or false. It may or may not. It may be changed to some other form. But here, because it is true or false, we are going to do it as true or false. Say whether the following statements are true or false. The first one, the writer met the lady for the first time at a theater. False. He did not meet her for the first time at a theater. The second one, 20 years back, the writer was very rich. Again, false. He was not very rich. He could hardly make ends meet. Now the third one, the lady wanted to have lunch with the writer at Luxembourg. Again, it is false. Now the fourth one, the writer did not expect to spend too much for the luncheon. This is true because he thought the money he had was enough to pay the bills, which of course did not turn out to be true, but he had this in mind that it would be enough. Now the fifth one, the lady wanted to have white wine, but it wasn't readily available. False. And the last one, the writer has compared the peaches to the blush of an innocent girl. Yes, The peaches which were served in the restaurant have indeed been compared to the blush of an innocent girl by the writer. Now, after this, you have answered the following questions. Please go through them thoroughly, because these could be changed into something else, into another form, and these could be asked. Then on the next page, page 24, you have to fill in the blanks about people's professions. Now, this is quite important from the point of view of exams, because the names here are in the help box. In the exam, you may or may not get it as option. You may get it as a fill in the blank. And if you get it as fill in the blank, or then you'll have to write the spelling on your own. If it is given in the options, then you are going to get the spelling. So please learn the spellings also. Now quickly, let us do this. The one who builds ships is called a shipwright. A dash compiles a dictionary. Who compiles a dictionary? A lexicographer. Third one, a dash stuffs the skins of dead animals to give them a lifelike appearance. Who stuffs the skins of dead animals? A taxidermist. Now the fourth one, the one who studies the working of a human mind is called a, now a person who studies mind and your mind is called a psychologist. Please remember, it starts with a P, but P is silent and we pronounce it as psychologist. And the subject is called psychology. Now the fifth one, the person who is in charge of giving assistance to the poor in places like a hospital is called an almoner. A-L-M-O-N-E-R. A stevedore, I'm doing the sixth one now. A stevedore helps to load or unload ships, to put things on ship. That means to load and unload, to take these things down. Now the seventh one, this one is very easy. A dash writes novels. Who writes novels? A novelist writes novels. And the eighth one, a chandelier makes or sells candles. So the spelling is C-H-A-N-D-L-E-R. You must remember the spelling. Now we go to the next lesson. That is Abu Ben Adam. And as you know, it's a very popular poem with a very good message for all of us, written by Lehan. You must go through the word bank. You must go through the poem. Now, in this section, the information about the writer is not given, but we have done that activity at the end, so you can go through this also. Now we'll do choose the correct answer. First one, Abu Ben Adam was a messenger of God, B, a religious person, C, a wealthy man. We know he was not a wealthy man. He was not a messenger of God because he was not the angel. He was visited by an angel, but he was not the angel. So which one is the correct option? He was a religious person. Now the second one, he was visited by an angel. B, God. C, a friend. He was not visited by a friend. He was not visited by God. But he was visited by the messenger of God. And what is another name for the messenger of God? By an angel. Now the third one. Ben Adam saw the visitor, A, looking at him, B, writing in a book, and C, holding lilies. No, the angel was not holding lilies or looking at him. The angel was busy, bent down, looking at a book, writing something in a book. And what was the color of the book? It was a book of gold. It was golden. Now the fourth and the last one in this exercise, which is true? There are three statements. Only one is true. Now please remember, in multiple choice in the exam, you are not going to get something which will have two correct answers. If it has something like two qualities which are true, it will be given as one option. So you cannot click in two places. Now, which is true? A, Ben Adam was too timid to speak to the visitor. B, Ben Adam was initially hesitant, but he finally spoke to the visitor. And C, Ben Adam spoke to the visitor fearlessly. We know the third one is right. He was not hesitant. He was not timid. He was not scared. From the beginning, he was bold enough to speak to the visitor or the angel. So he spoke to the visitor fearlessly. Now you could also get something on rhyming words. So please revise sounds and pronunciation and then appreciation section, because some phrase from the poem may be given which describes Abu Ben Adam's room or state of mind. Now which phrase describes Abu Ben Adam's room? Moonlight in his room. And state of mind or attitude, deep dream of peace or exceeding peace, that he was very peaceful. Now, second one, find a simile in the poem and explain its meaning. The simile is like a lily in bloom. Alliteration, there are a lot of examples of alliteration, and you have to see which one is given in the options and click on it. Awoke one night from a deep dream of peace. Deep dream is alliteration. And like a lily in bloom, lily and like have the l sound. So it is again an alliteration. Now we come to lesson number 6. David begins a new life. You have to remember the name of the novel from which it is taken, the name of the writer, and you have to go through the story thoroughly. You also have to read the information given about the writer and of course revise word bank. Now we come to A1, which is complete the following statements. First one, Miss Betsy had first seen David - where did she see David first? In Suffolk when he was born. You must know the spelling of Suffolk, S-U-F-F-O-L-K. Now the second one, David was made to work in a factory in London. And if only in a factory is given, you have to click on that. Now third one, by nature, Miss Betsy was kind and compassionate. And if one of these is given, kind or compassionate, you click on that. Now the fourth one, on his arrival at his aunt's house, David was given a bath and he was clothed in a shirt and a pair of trousers that belonged to Mr. Day. Now fifth one, Mr. Murdstone's attitude towards David was harsh, cruel, inconsiderate. Any of these could come. Now A2 again is multiple choice. Here you have more than one, but in the exam you get just one of these. So please remember to click on just one. One day, first one I am doing on page 38. One day Miss Betsy asked me, what do you think of Dick? I replied, he's very nice. Now, David found Dick to be a nice person because he was A, intelligent, B, a good companion, C, helpful, D, strange. Your two correct options are there, a good companion and helpful. But because you can't click on two in multiple choice, you'll get one of these and the other three will be wrong ones. Second, fortunately, Mr. Dick grew fond of me and I got to spend time with him. The memorable moments that I shared with Mr. Day, whose passion for flying kites was insurmountable, eased my discomfort to some extent. What was David's discomfort? Why did he feel uncomfortable? A having to go to school. This is not true because he really wanted to go to school. B not being able to adjust with the character of Mr. Day. That again is not true. They were friendly from the beginning. And D is missing his friends at work. No, he did not miss his friends at work. Which is the correct one? The prospect of meeting his stepfather. He was worried that his stepfather would come and take him back. And then he would have the same uncomfortable, harsh life again. So the third one is correct. The prospect of meeting his stepfather. Then you must revise all the answers to the questions. And of course, direct and indirect speech is there in our grammar part also. So you must revise all these three tables which are on page 40 and 41. These could come as match the columns or they could come in some other way, even true and false. Now, after this, we have the last lesson, that is David Begins a New Life 2. Of course, the writer is the same. And who is the writer? Charles Dickens. Now, complete the following statements. Miss Betsy was concerned about, she was worried about David's education. Second, she asked David if he would like to study in Canterbury, as Canterbury had good schools. So you can just write study in Canterbury. And the third one, Miss Betsy felt that she would get the best advice from Mr. Whitfield, who was a lawyer by profession. Fourth one, Mr. Whitfield offered to, what did he offer? He offered to host David's day till other arrangements could be made, or he offered to keep David with him in his house till some other arrangements could be made. Now the fifth one, Miss Betsy advised David. Now this is very important. She advised David, and which is very important, to avoid three vices. What are these three vices? Miss Betsy advised David to avoid the three vices of being mean, cruel and false. Mean, cruel and false. Now the sixth and the last one, David was conscious of the difference between, what was the difference, and he was also conscious of this difference between him or his and other students' level of education and experience. He knew he was far, far behind the other students in the school in experience and in the level of education. So David was conscious of the difference between the other students' level of education and experience. Then you have to go through the word bank in this lesson as well and revise all the answers and vocabulary section. Now then the other things are on reported speech, which of course you'll have to revise because reported speech is in your grammar section. Now I must remind you again, please go through all the lessons thoroughly. Questions and answers are not going to come because we are not giving long or short answers, but these can be changed into something else and given to you. So you need to revise questions and answers and other exercises as well. Now today's homework I'm going to put in the ERP app. Please see from there and do your homework. Thank you children. Till we meet again next week. Thank you. Take care.